students, welcome to Physics Simplified. We are performing a new experiment from optics, traveling microscope. So, we are finding out the refractive index of the given glass slab by using a traveling microscope. Microscope means we can see the dimensions of the microscale. So, we will be performing this experiment and we'll learn in details about how to use this instrument also. So, this is called a traveling microscope. Actually, it is a compound microscope, but it can travel this way, horizontally and also vertically. Now, this microscope, it is 10x written on the eyepiece. Means it magnifies the image 10 times. This is my eyepiece. You can see here. But this is the objective. Can show you the objective. This is the objective, which is having a very small focal length, and that under the objective, in front of the objective, we keep the object. Now, I can move this up and down and adjust the distance and remove the parallax and take the reading by focusing it on the object. Now, on the main scale, you can see here, there is a main scale and there is a vernier scale. Similarly, there is a main scale on the horizontal part and a vernier scale. I can move this like this for rough adjustment, and I can fix it by moving this screw so that it will not move. And here then I can do the fine adjustment. This is for the horizontal scale. Whereas for vertical scale, I can move it like this up and down, rough, and then after fixing this, I have to do the fine adjustment with this screw. As we have seen just now, that there is a main scale and there is a vernier scale. Main scale, 1 centimeter is divided into 20 equal parts, which you can see here. So if this is half centimeter, then this is 0.1 centimeter. And if this is 0.1 centimeter, this is 0.05 centimeter. This is my smallest division, which I have written here. Divided by number of divisions on the vernier scale. Divided by number of divisions on the vernier scale, which is equal to 0.001 centimeter. How many divisions are there on the vernier scale? Number of divisions on the vernier scale are 50. So in this experiment, we'll be finding the refractive index of this glass slab. You can see this glass slab. Now, this is the length, this is the breadth, this is the height. This is the glass slab. In order to find the refractive index, we have to learn some theory part of it. Look at this diagram. Let us say this is my glass slab, which is kept like this. At the base, this is the object, that is the cross mark, ink mark on one paper. What I have to do is, I have to first take the reading at the ink mark by using the traveling microscope. So first, let us learn how the ray diagram. First of all, the ray of light from O starts from here and incident on the surface of this point. And here at this point, X, it gets refracted because it travels from denser medium to rarer medium. N dash is the normal. So this ray, which is incident at this surface, moves away from the normal because it travels from denser medium to rarer medium. Observer is here and he observes this. So this ray falls on his eyes, and when it retraces the path from here to here, it appears to be at the point B. That means there is refraction. Now what happens? So this is my B point. After that, if we keep anything on the surface of this particular glass slab, let's say we take a point C, then this is the point on the surface, this is the depth, apparent depth, and this is the real depth. So what is the real depth? Real depth is C minus A. And what is the apparent depth? C minus B. So we have already done in our theory part how we get this formula. So real depth, apparent depth, refractive index is real depth upon apparent depth, C minus A upon C minus B. So in this experiment, we will be finding out the refractive index of glass by using this theory. So, now we will start taking the reading. This is the cross mark on the base of this microscope.
this cross mark we need to see from this eyepiece. You can know very well that this is the focusing screw. So what I do is, in the beginning itself, I take the focusing screw exactly on top. And what I do, this is the clarinet, I can move up and down. So I'll focus now. I can see a beautiful and clear image of the cross mark, and you can see the, if I want to do the little motion of this fine adjustment screw, I can move this. So this is the whole clarinet, I can move up and down. We are not going to touch this focus screw once we adjust it. We adjusted it on top. Now I see the reading. Once again, I can always move this, go for the clear image. I can get very clear image now. I take the first reading, and the first reading, I have to take the magnifying glass and I have to take the reading from here, and I get the reading as 8.2, and then I will see the coinciding division, and the coinciding division is 30. I'm explaining now how I'm getting it on the board, how to take the reading. So main scale is 3.2 and vernier reading is 30th mark. So 30 into least count. I'll explain it on the board now to you how we need to take the first reading. So we have taken the first reading. We get this kind of picture. The main scale is here on this side, and this is the vernier scale. I have magnified it. Look here, main scale 3.2 is here. Zero of the vernier is here, and this is 3.25. You can very well see the main scale 3.2 and 3.25, there's zero in between. It is not exactly in between. So the main scale reading X is equal to 3.2 centimeter plus this much distance. How much is this? So we need to see the coinciding division. You can see, if we consider this as 50 markings divided to 50 equal parts, then this has crossed the 25th marking, that we can see by intelligent guesswork observation. So now let's see, that means the coinciding division has to be about 25. You can see, this is 50 markings, this has to be 25 in the middle. It is above that. So let's see from above 25, keep on seeing, and you can see very well that 30th division of the vernier scale is coinciding with any division on the main scale that we can see. So we have to write vernier reading is 30 and multiplied by least count 0.001 centimeter. So if you combine this is X plus Z is 30 into least count. So we get this reading as 3.230 centimeter. This is my first reading of the cross mark. We write that reading in our observation. Now I keep the glass slab on top of this. See now, you can very well see there is a upshift. It is shifted upward. So now when I see from the microscope, I see the blurred image. I have to focus it. Remember, don't touch this focusing screw now. We have to move the whole clarinet, and we take it on top, and we go for the next reading. And I get here very nice reading, very clear reading. I get it. This is my second reading. I can see very well the clear image of the cross mark. Let me take the observation now. I can see very well that the reading is 3.85. So 0 is in between the two, 3.85 and 3.9. So I get the reading, main scale is 3.85 and the coinciding division is 37. So the total reading, I get it. I'm again explaining you how I'm getting the reading. Now we have taken the second reading. What have we done? We have kept the glass slab on top of the cross mark, and we have tried to see the reading from the eyepiece, and we have seen to it that the carriage moves in such a way that at one particular position we get the very clear image of that cross mark, and we get this reading. Let me show the reading on this board clearly. You can see very well that the marking has gone above. So now from 3.2, it has gone to 3.85. What is it? This is 3.85 and this is my 0, and this is my 3.2.
9. So this is my 3.9. So what happens is your 0, here it is. Your 0 lies between 3.85 and 3.9. So the main scale is 3.85. Let us look at the coinciding division. You can see very well it has crossed so much distance. I can show you here like this. It has crossed so much distance. It has crossed 25. So let us see which division is coinciding. And we find that division number 37. Can you see here? 30, 31, 32, 33, 34, 35, 36. And division 37 is coinciding with the mean scale line. So what do we get? The mean scale is x is 3.85 plus 0.037. So we get the reading as 3.887 centimeter. So this is the second reading we get. So we got R2 as 3.887 centimeter. Now let's go for the third reading. We have to put this chalk particles. I can just put the chalk particle. I can just put it like this so that they are exactly touching the surface. By the way, why we put the chalk particles on the surface? Because we have to focus on the surface. And now it's a transparent surface, so we cannot focus anything. So we have to focus an object on the surface, and the object is the chalk powder. So if we get a very clear image from this microscope of the chalk powder, that means I got the surface reading. So now what I do, again I take this clarity, I move this, loosen this screw and take it on top, and I can see very clear image of the chalk powder. I get the very very clear image of the chalk powder. I fix it. Now let me see the third reading. The third reading I get it as 5.1 main scale, and the vernier scale I get it as 42. 42 is coinciding. I'll explain to you how to take the reading. Now we have taken the third reading. Third reading is on the surface of this transparent glass slab. We cannot take any reading on the surface just like that. So we need to keep something on the glass slab. So we have put the chalk powder on top of the slab. But we have focused the microscope, and naturally we had to take the microscope on top, the whole clear image on top, and then we are taking the reading. We get this step of reading. We get main scale 0 lies between 5.1 and 5.15. But you can see very well 0 is more close to 5.15. So if I consider this as 50 markings, it has crossed 30, 40 also it must have crossed and gone ahead. So this distance we want to find out. So main scale is 5.1 centimeter. And this much distance we need to find out. So we have to now go ahead and see which division is coinciding. From observation we can find that a division must be above, because it has crossed the midpoint of 5.1 and 5.15. So let's see where it is. If you go to see, we can see very well that 42 divisions. Can you see here 40, 41, 42, 43, 44. So the 42nd division, that is the division coinciding, is this one. It coincides with the main scale line. So we need to write the reading as 0.042 as the vernier reading. 42 into least count. 42 multiplied by 0.001 Liskov centimeter. So this becomes 0.042. This 0.042 added to this, and we get the total reading as 5.142. That is my R3 reading. So we have three readings here: R1, R2, and R3. R1 reading we have here, R2 reading we have here, and R3 reading we have here. So these are the three readings we'll be having. So now R1 is the first reading. We focused on the cross mark directly. We got this reading. R2 is the second reading. There is the apparent reading where we have seen the upshift of the cross mark from the glass slab. This is the second reading. And the third reading, R3, is the surface reading where we are focused on the chalk powder on the surface of the glass slab. We have three readings now. What is real depth? R3 minus R1. And what is apparent depth? R3 minus R2. Therefore, we get this as R3 minus R1, 1.912 upon 1.255. After calculations, you get the refractive index of glass slab. We get it is equal to 1.524, which is very, very close. I mean, it's perfect answer we are getting. Very close to the actual value of glass. So this is our first reading. So now in the second part of the experiment, we need to take a second observation. So we will keep the glass slab this way. So first we have to take the reading on the cross mark. I got the reading. Then I keep this on top of it. Try to see the image again, once again through this. I get the second reading. And then I will put again the chalk particles on top of this. And I will focus on this. I take the third reading. So again R1, R2, R3 we get. Now, what I'll do, I'll take the third observation. Third observation, I'll get both the glass slabs on top of it. So when we take both the glass slabs on top of it, again, first reading we have to take for the cross wire, second reading through the glass slab, and third reading, again, put the chalk on this and take the third reading. So we have got three sets of observation, and we need to find out the refractive index of the given glass slab. So now, we have taken the second reading, and after substituting all the getting all the values, you get the second value of mu as 1.510, and the third value also of mu is 1.510. Then we need to take the average, and so the average of all three refractive indices, we get it as 1.514. We get a very good value. Experiment is successful. See you once again in the next session. Thank you.